Oke guys, kita masuki ke game pertama ya, antara Aures di Singapura melawan NPFL. Oke, Grand Final ya guys ya. Kita lihat aja guys, King Diablo. King Diablo ada Skocak. Iya. Terus ada si siapa, si Bray ya. Oke lah, ini penentuan guys, kira-kira siapa yang bakalan ke MSG Riot nanti ya. Juga ada sepuh lol si juga cuy. Tapi bener-bener ya guys ya, ada Skocak bener-bener sukses guys di Singapura guys. Season kemarin juara guys dia, sekarang entahlah ya. Kita lihat dulu bos. From the side of Hades is on the key target.
Looking at the rotations coming up from the side of RSG right now. Yep, it's going to be Bray picking up the Lethal Wanderer. We'll be walking on back. In terms of the lane priority right here, I'm expecting CS should have a slide. But also NIP Flash on Diablo could just easily rotate. So which means that RSG needs to be a little bit careful with regarding with any form of invades.
Yeah, and double Impure Rage coming out from the side of NIP Flash, pretty standard. But looking at the Concussive Blast coming out from Lolzy, right?
You
want him to go for this tanky Cho, you want him to go for this like really disrupting team fight as much as possible from the side of Cho. And that's what you want. You want his ulti.
CS itu bukan customer service ya guys, ya beda guys itu guys.
Yep, don't forget ladies and gents, NIP Flash is going for more of a late game kind of scenario. And don't forget they can always fix the waves very easily with the help of Diablo, right? If he's not having a very good game, he always goes back to the macro Benedetta as well.
And we do see both mid laners currently at the top lane. They do want this level 4 as fast as possible before this turtle fight right here.
Oh, don't forget, Cho with the knock-up as well. Also kind of combines very well with Hades. You already start to see what NIP Flash is already
pertama, guys,
as
ya.
The turtle fight should be starting very soon. RSG nowhere near the turtle though. Bray is on the other side, is making a beeline towards the turtle right now.
Slow but steady pacing
for both
ultimate. Oh, the final blow, feathered airstrike is going to be committed, but Bray's going to take the turtle. He's got the fast fingers, and it looks like Hades is going to back off. Cortese has to use the flicker. Lolzy will get back to safety, so it looks like RSG came out on top.
Yep, great start for the side of RSG already, and Bray is going to press the issue right here. Hades looking down low.
They got him with the Brave Assault, not letting Hades just farm, and they're going to take away the orange buff as well. Lolzy maybe contest for that one.
Maybe is a very
ada Skocaknya tumbang guys ya.
Lolzy might be giving up his life here. He is immobilized, but Bray will not be over committing onto the tier 2 turret here. And with the CC, right, you want to take as much segmented team fights as possible. Like closer, he will be looking to try and find these pickoffs, trying to be on Diablo duty, just basically.
Diablo.
And Diablo,
final blow keeps it alive, but now the tower is going to push. They're going to do a lot of damage, structural damage on this. Derry's making a rotation as well, and Diablo, all he can do is stand back and watch.
They elect
the final blow.
Do
he does have it. The heart guard is going to be committed onto Diablo. Diablo's going to be the first to fall, though, and Cortese shows up. It's just like, hey, what happened, buddy?
And yeah, that was the hard guard from the side of Cortese that was stolen with IMU, right? But still, Derry did not need to require to use of the hard guard at all. So they will have it for this bottom lane fight that might ensue from the side of CS.
But the heavens are secured by Vanix. That's first item. More on the DPS kind of style. It shows that Vanix wants to go into the end game, the late game, right? Yes, right now RSG, they should have a bit of a stronger level 4 power spike. But wait until NIP Flash gets started to get items, especially Vanix, especially Cortese. Those things are starting to hurt. But however, Bray is already a monster, stomping around the Land of Dawn, just threatening an NIP Flash.
And that's why we see the tank meta being so prevalent here in MPLSG, because you have so much frontline ability, and on top of that, you have the sustainability with the Angela as well. And Lolzy and Hades, they do not provide that kind of like sustainability. They're going for that catch meta as much as possible. So yeah, what you said about NIP Flash, they are going for the long game, and they will have to find as many pickoffs as possible.
Second turtle is already up for the taking. RG and NIP Flash, they're nowhere near the turtle though. Lolzy will be able to find that out, but Bray spotted already for the airstrike, already committed. Cortese getting half HP.
Yeah, it's gonna just stop that. I mean, they're not gonna really commit for this one. Lousy's gonna back off, but this, I mean, everybody's a little bit low, which is a little bit worrying for this turtle here. But they do have Diablo joining. Closer's gonna hit the yo-yo blitz. He's gonna do a little bit of area damage, so to speak, onto Cortese, but he's gonna recall back.
Yeah, and for NIP Flash, they're just posturing for position as much as possible. They just want these pickoffs.
Tapi lol sih dari dulu emang cowoknya bagus banget loh guys dia guys. Harusnya mimpi buruk RSG ini ketemu cow lol sih guys.
Great start, NOD already secured by the side of Kurt TZ first. This kind of counteract against the healing coming out from Dairy. And next up, you can see Vanix is already going for the Stardium Scythe. Notice CS, instead of going for the one that we always see recently in terms of the attack speed, kind of Roger, going back to the Windtalker and this battle kind of build. So, RSG is looking to spike hard, and I feel like they've already hit kind of like
the post in terms of the items,
but we need to take a look at execution, especially for the second turtle.
Oh, you heard this?
Oh, Hades.
Ooh.
Thought about it. He's gonna just go back to this turtle, but Vanix has now joined. All five members of NIP Flash are sticking around. Closer making a flank, trying to just scout out, see what you can do, and maybe you get lucky, get some sort of pickoff.
And with this CS, just looking at the top lane, managing to cut the creep waves and getting a lot of farm for himself, Diablo has to be on the duty so far. But the turtle is starting.
All feathered airstrike, and they're going to hit with Cortese. He dashes away, but Vanix has already taken the turtle. The Brave Assault, the Energy Eruption onto Lalzi, but Godzilla, yeah, they have the damage, but he's just so tanky thus far. But the Appraiser's Wrath slices him down, and Bray will take that.
And yep. Both teams still neck-to-neck in terms of net worth, 16,000 to 16,000, one turtle each. But CS, he has been racking
up. Suara casternya gak imbang, guys. Yang satu gede, yang satu enggak.
Yeah, NIP Flash respecting RSG's power spikes right now, right? This is not the time where they're looking for a fight. Diablo goes in for the ultimate.
Into the ultimate, but he's just gonna back off. But Bray, ex-teammate, he's like, come on, buddy, let's
Diablo,
go.
Diablo.
No? Wet noodle fight?
Panik dapet ntar bawah, guys, ya.
So with that said, both teams are actually still neck and neck in terms of net worth, in terms of the macro gameplay, but in terms of map control. NIP Flash, they did get one tower.
Oh, they found guys, Closer. Buset, they got him knocked up.
Diablo will get credit for that one. That's going to be the first kill, and that's buset, a pretty big win for NIP Flash.
Yeah, and that's the thing about the CC, right? It's still extremely burstable when it comes down to these team fights. Oh. It can get caught easily, and Hades would be on the job.
Yep, RG is starting to start to raid the side, the countryside. It's the one that we saw earlier just now in the day where they started to just make sure that CS start pushing down turrets. NIP Flash is also going to respond in trade. But right now, RSG, you don't see them actually going very hard on the kills because NIP Flash is not allowing them to.
And just key positioning from NIP Flash at the moment. They troll going for the engage.
Said.
Oh, they found Bray. Lalzi goes in for this one. They got the way the dragon kicks him back, and Godzilla's gonna get the kill. Bray's down for the count, though, but Vanix
set up for the Raulin. Itu.
Hades now here. He's not thinking about it. Oh yeah, he's not
gonna go. Cortez hampir di Raulin, guys ya.
Already expended the ultimate down at the bottom lane. Yes, Lalzi is a good kill if I can catch Bray. If I can also catch closer down the bottom lane. So right now, NIP Flash, if you notice, the gold lane swings back into their favor.
Yeah, and Closer is just not having a good day. Just consistently being caught by Hades is not a position that he wants to be in. He wants to try and play keep away as much as possible, but the Astral Migration just completely committed onto him. Just very well done from the side of NIP Flash in terms of the macro gameplay, in terms of responding to what RSG want to do so far.
Yep, Godzilla started to become the problem. Speaking of Godzilla, there's a better airstrike on
Vanix. Vanix
just barely gets away.
Godzilla flies over the wall. They have the energy eruption on Cortese. He's getting bursted. Cortezinya. He does go down. The CS is going to get credit. Lalzi getting run in. They don't care about the tower. Oh, Lalzi somehow survives. Bray, though.
Wah, darahnya seoprit, guys. Hadesnya pun sama.
Hah? CS is going to go down. Godzilla's going to go down.
Mati.
And it looks like NIP Flash somehow came out the victors.
Dude, that could have gone so bad for the side of NIP Flash.
Oh, terlalu OP, guys. Terlalu OP, guys, ya. Buset dah.
Oh, that Vanix going to back off. Not really much gonna happen, but Bray still
terlalu
up in front
OP,
again. You're
terlalu
talking about him being a monster. You're starting to feel the effects. Yeah. He's 2-1-3.
2-1-3. Very scary scoreline to deal with, but now the objective of choice will be the Lord from the side of NIP and Flash. And RSG, they can't
yeah,
do anything
udah pasti dapet sih ya.
You want to have a dominant lead as much as possible. You don't want to take two fights.
Yep, we talk about the late game. NIP Flash is like, yeah, I'm in the late game now. Even Godzilla using Feather Airstrike just to kind of wave clear, but Kurt Easy takes it away. Vanix securing the Holy Crystal already, and NIP Flash is looking to clash.
5 banding 5, menit 9, guys.
No,
for pushing their lead and choking the opponents out. RSG, they are feeling the strain right now. All the players, they are down in terms of gold lead, in terms of map advantage as well. With the Lord, they would want to prioritize the mid lane, and RSG are responding very well. They don't want the mid turret to go down.
Oh, look at that. Micro Jackson on the way up top lane. Diablo fixing that side.
Portage.
RSG, they're congregating in the middle, making sure that mid lane doesn't fall. And now NIP Flash is looking for more pickoffs. But RSG, what's the top side?
Slow but steady advance from NIP Flash at the moment. Using the Lord to the advantage. Their sights are set. They really want this mid-tier turret. It will open up a lot of the map. But RSG are looking to respond.
Oh, Hades goes in. Feathered Airstrike. Mm, they do a lot of damage. But Derry's the first to fall. But they do get advantage. They got Cortese as well. And now they're on the run. Hades is trying to get on out of there. Lousy's doing what he can to attract their attention.
Flickers
over the wall. Oi. He's going to be fine. He dashes. Wah, that was minimal damage, I would say.
Not only just that, bottom lane for the side of NIP Flash. Taken down. Lord is the MVP right here. NIP Flash, we're just distracting RSG in the mid lane.
Yes.
Yeah, and with that, the macro advantage just went to NIP Flash's favor, despite the fact that they had the favorable trade from the side of RSG, right? They took down two for Derry, but they lost inhibitor turret. That's so much map control going towards the side of NIP Flash. That would make their future lords a lot easier.
Yep. Usually you expect NIP Flash, you know, with this first lord, you want to clear off the first tier, the whole second tier, right? So that you only have the base turrets left on the side of RSG, but NIP Flash wasn't able to convert that, but at the very least, they took down bottom lane. And now, if you notice, in terms of the map push and pull, right, RSG, that lord is going to be spawning up top, whereas it's on the far side. So which means that RSG needs to constantly go back and clear that wave, especially when it's a super minion wave.
Yeah, it's going to be extremely hard for RSG to claw back right now, but still, net worth only 2,000 gold away for both sides.
Still winnable though, 2.7k, we've seen comebacks coming happening around the 5k mark as well. And if you notice, NIP Flash is just making sure they are controlling around the mid lane right now. RSG, they cannot push out, if not, they're gonna get punished.
Oh, Hades goes in, spatial migration, the feathered airstrike can be turned. Bray's running out of this one. He seems to be going the wrong way.
Bray.
He's gonna fall, Heart Guard is gonna be committed. Diablo taking a lot of damage. CS dashes over the wall, he's gonna be fine, but Bray goes down.
Yep, top side kicks crack open as well. Now the Lord has been enhanced. Don't forget, an RSG has to go down to the bottom lane to fix that. Big ultimates already committed by the side of Derry and especially Godzilla. Godzilla's where the airstrike should be up. NIP Flash will take the opportunity to brace
NIP Flash going for the objective. Just 20 seconds before the Lord spawns, right? They want to take away the retribution. Rage is not available. They cannot contest the Lord from the side of RSG. And now they have the enhanced Lord. They're going to go for more outer turrets once again.
Oke lah, Rose Gold Meteor udah diamankan oleh CS ya. Feather Airstrike.
But now it's going to be Feather Airstrike committed just to make sure that wave clear around the mid lane so the NIP Flash couldn't push in. Godzilla is using these Feather Airstrike more like a defensive one, and that's not a really good sign for RSG.
Yeah, the Lord still available, but the creeps have been dealt with. They will be able to deal with this Lord, but can they deal with the split pushing Macro Jackson? That is Diablo on the top lane.
Macro Jackson. Indeed, top side already pushed in. The Lord has been dealt by the side of RSG. NIP Flash goes back to the regular things that they want to do in taking down the mid lane turret. And now all of a sudden, NIP Flash has unlocked all the resources from the side of RSG.
Yeah, RSG, you're just waiting for the mistake from NIP Flash at the moment. Just trying not to give away any of the lives in vain and just trying to hope for a favorable trade. They do have the favorite team fight, yeah. Right? They have the Fredrin, they have the Feather Airstrike. The only thing that they lack is the AoE that's coming.
Masih nunggu Lord lagi kah guys ini guys? Atau nunggu momen cuy? Biasanya itu ada momen dari LoL sih loh. Ya kita lihat aja lah. Ya hades. Iya. Kalau nggak recall nggak itu ya guys ya, kurang lah, kurang.
Possible, but the one that's limiting on all these heals is the first item choice coming off of Cortese, right? The NOD so early on. Vanix has already secured the Holy Crystal, as I pointed out earlier. Now with the Athena Shield, just to make sure that he survived the barrage. Coming up,
Synergy Eruption on the Lousy. He's about half life.
Wow, Bray mana mati, guys?
The Feathered Airstrike, the Electro Final Ball. Just kind of cutting it off. They do have the Heart Guard, though.
Nah, Godzilla. Waduh,
not able to do it. Derry's down as well. And it's in a complete wipeout. And NIP Flash are looking to just end this game. game. This looks to be a completely
ramai banget guys. Buset. Wah, gila.
So decisive coming out from NIP Flash. Taking game number 1.
GG guys. Terlalu OP ya guys ya. Apalagi Diablo guys ya, yang awalnya di RSC sekarang di NPLV ya guys ya. NPFL lah ya, makin GG lah guys. Oke lah ya, thank you ya. Kita lanjut ke match selanjutnya bos. Bye bye.